Hey, this is VSDC channel, and today we're going to talk about transformation effects from the video effects menu in VSDC. Transformation effects are designed to help you transform or distort a video without drastically changing the image, as special effects do. Let's have a look at each option in the transformation menu one by one. The first effect, aptly named Flip, helps you flip the object in the scene vertically or horizontally. The perspective effect creates an illusion that the viewers are looking at the video from an unusual angle. This effect comes in handy when you want to place a title or an image on some surface in your video. You can switch between vertical and horizontal perspectives and set the angle values. Plus, you can choose to change the perspective angle dynamically over time, so the effect will look like this. Skew looks slightly similar to perspective, but in this case the rotation is happening around the diagonal axis. Again, you can set the desired skew angle and use the nonlinear parameter change graph to create a dynamic effect. Moving on, by default the shift effect literally shifts the video 100 pixels up and 100 pixels to the right from its original position. It will come in handy if you know you need to shift the file on the scene, but you don't want to manually drag it with the mouse. The rotation effect is pretty self-explanatory. By default, it applies a 30-degree angle rotation to the object clockwise, but you can easily change the angle value or, and that's pretty interesting, the point around which the object will be rotating. Resampling, in this case, means multiplying, so when you apply this effect, you can get a multiplication of the original image or video by as many times as you want. Like most effects, this one looks more interesting when you apply it dynamically. Zoom is the most popular transformation effect. As the name suggests, it allows you to zoom in and out on a video. But we aren't just talking about zooming the entire scene as is, because you can actually pick a spot you want to zoom in and set the zoom in pace by using the initial and final values. Also, you can make a cool pulsation effect using the nonlinear parameter change graph. The mirror effect creates a reflection of the video, or any other object you've applied the effect to. You can set the angle at which the reflection will be visible, and you can decide whether you want it vertical or horizontal. The crop effect is a pretty versatile tool. It helps you quickly crop a video or crop and resize at the same time, which is essentially a great alternative to the zoom effect. If you think you can make use of this tool, we suggest watching a dedicated tutorial on our channel. Next in line is the distortion effect that brings several presets and allows you to customize the distortion based on the selection option. Such effects as twirl, polar, wave, and fisheye are available in the menu. Lens distortion is a common real-life effect produced by a camera lens. It typically manifests itself by making straight lines in the video curvy. It's often used when you need to imitate a video from a security camera or a peephole. That was the last transformation effect from the menu. Thank you for watching this far. Now take a moment to subscribe and stay tuned for the next video.